Anderson Cooper is keeping them honest. AC 360, CNN weeknights, 8 Eastern.
Tony, first of all, I'm so glad that you're okay. Walk us through what happened.
I was there alone, actually, and found a buddy of mine was at the mountain with his son. And he said, come on down and meet me down at the base. We did a little hike up, 20 minutes or so, got our breath, because obviously you're at that point, especially a base, and you're way up there. And we were all getting ready to go, and he said, now take it easy, because if you go down here, you know, you twist an ankle, you lose something, it's really hard to get you out. And I thought, you know, I think I went back to my military days and, like, safety officer, and I said, well, what if there's an avalanche? Just kind of, you know, threw that question out, and he looked up, and he said, well, ski left or ski right? Like, matter of fact. And somebody in the back said, make sure you cover your mouth. I hear it's hard to breathe. And with that, we were off. And we jumped in, and I bet it wasn't, you know, a minute later. I'm talking 100 feet in. Heard a sound. Like,
what was it, like a rumble?
No, more like the earth kind of moaning a little bit, giving you a warning, if it will. And then it just, the snow started to move underneath you. I mean, wherever you could look at your feet, the snow was moving downhill.
So I just can't even imagine it. What does it feel like to be tossed around in the middle of something like that?
You're basically gasping for air and fighting to just figure out which way is up and down. And there's moments where, like, you're so tight and enclosed and can't breathe. And I know at one point I could swear I was upside down. I don't know if that's possible, but I could swear I was upside down, rolling down the hill, and I thought, this is not going to end well.
How long did it take before they dug you out?
Well, so once the snow stops, it really, like, weights you down, and at that point is when you're supposed to, I guess, get your hands to your mouth. I wasn't able to, and
you couldn't lift your arms.
No, I mean it came quick, but it comes to a pretty much a screeching halt, and it stopped, and like you'd mentioned, a small hole opens up, and I can breathe and see the sun and the blue sky, and I probably was there 5-10 minutes before someone found me.
Why did that hole form? Was it just luck? You just were lucky that you're.
I'm a God-fearing man. That's why I believe that, you know, luck, fate, and you know, a lot of things came at once to open that little space. And again, it was the pictures. It wasn't much of a hole when he came to dig me out.
And then look at the smile on your face in that picture says it all. You must have just been. I mean, you thought you were going to die.
Oh yeah, it was pretty sure. I mean, I was hoping to live. Let's put it that way. I didn't think I was going to die. I hope I'm an optimistic guy, so I was hoping and praying to live, not saying, you know, what should I have done in life? I mean, there's no time for that.
Were you thinking about your wife? Were you thinking about your son? Were you?
That was the only three thoughts. My wife, who was expecting our second, and my 18-month-old little son, and God, hoping that, you know, he would help me through it.